السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. My brothers, my time is very short, so let me get straight to it. Brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has created us for two sole purposes. Two. Nothing more and nothing less. Number one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you to know Him and to worship Him and Him alone. This is your purpose on earth. Wallahi, I make qasam by Allah Azza wa Jal. You were not created to buy houses, build cars, and buy this and sell that, and go fishing and go here and go there. None of this pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You were created to worship Him and Him alone. This is your role in this world, to establish deen in your life. And what deen? What deen do I have to establish? The deen of La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. To say that there is no ilah. That there is no ilah. There is no God. There is no power. There is no kudra. There is nothing on this earth except Allah Azza wa Jal. It is Allah who does. It is Allah who makes. It is Allah who breaks. It's Allah who gives. It's Allah who takes. To understand this, and not just to say it on the tongue. You see, everyone says this on the tongue. No, this is not what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking for. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that no child or no money or nothing will make you successful on that day illa, except those who come to Allah biqalbin what? Salim. With a pure heart. With a heart that has full conviction in La ilaha illallah. With a heart that has no doubt in it whatsoever that Allah is the greatest, Allah is the King, that nothing on this earth can harm you except by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that your rizq, your sustenance that comes to you, it comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, doesn't come through your work, doesn't come from your boss, doesn't come because mashallah you're a shatur and you were in the right place at the right time. No, it came because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent it to you. So understand that the King, He's sitting on the throne not because of His progeny, not because of His understanding, not because of His lineage. He's there because Allah put Him there. The one who's sweeping and cleaning the streets, He's not there due to His lack of understanding. He's not there due to His lack of education. He's not there because of His progeny or His lineage. He's there because Allah put Him there. And your condition now is here because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put you there. So it is your job to understand, this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to see, that La ilah, that there is no God, there is no might, illallah. And what's the other thing? That Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is Rasulullah. That his path and his way is not the best. The way of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, it's not the best way. It's the only way. And wallah al-azim, until you understand this fully, you will forever suffer. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from you. To establish deen in your life. To bring full deen. That the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam becomes more beloved to you. Malish, forgive me. Maybe this is a bit extreme. But it's a concept. Understand. Until the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Until squatting in the toilet and cleaning your backside with your left hand becomes more beloved to you than the whole world and everything it contains, because it's the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. This is the deen that you need to bring into your life. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking for. To establish deen, my brother, in your life. Full deen. What does the hadith say? He says, "Thalathun man kunna fihi wajada halawat al-iman." Rasulullah is saying that there are three things. If they are present in your life, you will taste the sweetness of iman. What do we all cry about, my brothers? Ramadan comes and Ramadan goes, and I go to the masjid and I'm reading Quran, but there's nothing in my heart, brother. I'm dead. Why? And yakun Allah wa rasulihi ahabba ilayhim mimma siwahuma. Until Allah and His Prophet become more beloved to you than anything and everything on the face of this earth, wallahi, you will never taste iman. You will never taste the sweetness of iman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in probably the harshest verse in the Quran, when He's addressing sahaba, not hypocrites, not munafiqeen, not kuffar, sahaba, He's telling Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "Qul ya Muhammad," tell your companions, tell the best ummah to ever walk the earth, إن كان آباءكم وأبناءكم وإخوانكم وأزواجكم وعشيرتكم وأموال اقترفتموها وتجارة تخشون كسادها ومساكن ترضونها أحب إليكم. Tell them, يا محمد,
that if their fathers and their mothers and their sons and their children and their extended friends and family, if their businesses and their cars and their money and their papers are more beloved to them min Allah wa rasulihi wa jihadin fi sabili, until this comes into your life, my brother, what's the promise of Allah? فَتَرَبَّصُوا حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ اللَّهُ بِأَمْرِهِ وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْفَاسِكِينَ. Then wait, for the punishment is verily coming to you soon. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from you, to establish deen in your life. And what's the other thing, my brother? To establish deen in the ummah. شَرَعَ لَكُم مِّنَ الدِّينِ مَا وَصَّى بِهِ نُوحًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, verily it has been ordained upon you what was brought unto who? نوح والذي أوحينا إليك, and to you, يا محمد. وما وصينا به إبراهيم وموسى وعيسى, and what was ordained unto إبراهيم وموسى وعيسى. What is it? أن أقيموا الدين, to establish دين. This is your role, my brother. This is our role, to establish دين, full دين on this earth. My brothers, go and see the condition of this world. We just came back from Egypt. We just came back from Egypt. Bilad al-Azhar, 90 million people, 95% Muslims. Go. You know what the growing trend now is amongst the youth? Wallah al-Azim, people I met myself and spoke to myself. You know what the growing trend is now? Atheism. Atheism. And this is a wallah, someone who's a miskeen, hultu ta'bani, you know, look, you know, this guy's a fa'ir, doesn't have money, so he's lost hope in Allah. No. Educated, has money, proper position in the community, says, we prove the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I don't need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in my life. This world was always here and it'll always be here. This is, yes, atheism, naam. Why? Because the da'wah has stopped. Because fishing you and the boys has become more important to you than establishing the deen on this earth. That's why. This is your role. This world you're living in is rubbish. Wallahi, it's rubbish. Rasulullah is walking in the marketplace. Live the moment, live the moment. Rasulullah is with his sahaba. Picks up a dead goat, a carcass, stinking, rotting, flies around it. So he picks it up by its ear with araf. He looks to his sahaba, he says, who will buy this of me for one dirham? One dirham, who will buy it of me? So the sahaba, yani, Ya Rasulullah, yani, what are we going to do with that? He says, type, who will take it off me? Yahi, don't pay. Take it for free. Have it for free. They said, Ya Rasulullah, even if it was alive, it's a defected goat. Now it's dead. And it stinks and it reeks, and you want me to take it? He says to him, by Allah, this is your Habib. Listen to the words of your Prophet. He says, by Allah, this world and what it contains is less in the eyes of Allah than this dead carcass is to you. And we've left our ummah. We're chasing after the little luxuries of this world. Go and see the condition. My brothers, this is your responsibility. Your Habib, your Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to cry the nights. Why? Why? Why would you cry the nights, Ya Rasulullah, when Al-Maqam Al-Mahmud was given to you anyway? You're already going straight to paradise. He cried the nights for you and I. He cried the nights because he's seen these days were coming. He cried the nights because you now, go, forget what's happening around the world. In Auburn, wallah al-azim, in Auburn, Lebanese Muslim father is sleeping with his 7-year-old daughter. Here in Auburn. Astaghfirullah. Of course, brother, of course, when there's no da'wah in this world, this is what happens to the condition, naam. This is what happens to the world. Your sister and my sister, my brother, we sit here, you know, mashallah, the boys, when they sit down, he speaks about his ard. Never mind your ard. This is the ard of Rasulullah and the sahaba who gave their life for you and I to say, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Go and see what's happening out there, brother. She's walking into a tattoo parlor to have some kafir tattoo the name of her boyfriend, bro, on her ass. She's getting the paw print of a kalb, and this on her here. Why? Because it's the in thing. And you and I, mashallah, we're talking about fishing at the end of the year. Your job is to establish deen on this earth. The ummah is crying. Wallah al-Azim, the ummah is crying for help. And you know what the poison is? You and I were convinced that this is the job of the mashayikh, mashallah. This is the job of the mashayikh. No, my brother, this is your job and it's your amana, and I'm telling you by Allah, you will be questioned for this on the day of judgment.
We have a job, we have a responsibility, we have an amana. We were in Egypt. Let me tell you, brother, let me, you know, boys here, mashallah, you know, wherever you go, yeah, brother, jihad, let's talk about jihad. Wallahi, wallahi, the next guy who speaks about jihad, slap him across the face and tell him, wake up to yourself, brother. Go and see in Egypt, your sisters from Bilad al-Sham. Yes, I seen it with my own eyes. Your sisters from Bilad al-Sham, they're going to Egypt for prostitution. For prostitution, because of the ahwal are so bad. Naam, prostitution, yes.
It's all right, relax, brother. Dakhlak, please tell me, what's the year model of your car?
Fah, did you see the latest one that came out? And this is what's happening. And this is what's happening, my brothers. My brothers, we have an amana. We have a responsibility. Wallahi, 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 go out there and see the condition of this world. Go out there and see the condition of this world. The Shaykh was giving a talk, a small talk about Tahara. About Tahara. So one of the brothers, he came up to him after, he says to him, Shaykh, Malash, yani, you were speaking about making ghusl. So some yes. So some Shaykh, you only make ghusl when you commit zina, huh? Married for 20 years. Married for 20 years. Been sleeping with his, he's been sleeping with his wife, huh? With his wife. And he thinks that you only perform ghusl when you are, when you commit the act of zina. And he's praying. And he's praying. My brothers, this is your responsibility. Wallahi, this is your deen. If you're waiting for Sheikh Fulan and Sheikh Fulan to come and save you, wallahi, woe to you. Woe to you. Just like how you don't wait for anyone to come and pay your bills, why do you wait for people to come and teach you your deen? Why? Why? Why are we waiting for this person and that person? This is your responsibility. And my brothers, Malish, forgive me, I'll leave you with this last hadith, authentic narration. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, so that you and I understand the importance of da'wah in our life. He says, "La ta'murunna bil ma'roof wa la tanhawunna 'anil munkar." Your Prophet is saying what? He says, "You will enjoy that which is good and you will forbid that which is evil." Or what? "Aw la yushikanna Allah an yub'ath 'alaykum 'iqaban min." Or verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will send down His punishment to you. What is the punishment of Allah? He says, "Tuma tad'una lahu wa la yustajabu lakum." He says, you will raise your hands and make dua, and Allah will not accept your dua. This is His punishment. 4 million people in the haram every single year. 4 million people raise their hands and cry before Allah. Ya Allah, Masjid al-Quds. Ya Allah, Palestine. Ya Allah, Syria. Ya Allah, Babar. I want to ask you something. Is Allah deaf when a'udhu billah? Allah, Allah. Is He deaf, yani? He can't hear them? Allah is blind when a'udhu billah, yani? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can't see them? Isn't He the one who says, when you ask me, I will give? But what's happening? What's happening? The ummah is crying. No, my brother, there is a prerequisite. You have to. There is a condition. There is a condition before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can you accept your dua. And what is this condition? That you become a da'i ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is your role. This is your role. To establish deen in my life. What sort of deen? Full deen. And to establish deen in this ummah. Jazakallah khairan, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika, mashallah.